A big setback for voters in getting a say on whether to privatize St. Louis Lambert International Airport. Now, there was a bill to give voters a stick, and a big one, in discussions over Lambert's future. What happened when it came to a vote? That's tonight's You Paid For It.
Oh, I'm horribly disappointed about what happened. You know, we had a board bill that would require a public vote in the event that the city of St. Louis moves forward with the privatization of our public asset, our public airport.
St. Louis Alderwoman Kara Spencer was the bill's sponsor. The legislation went down to defeat in the Aldermanic Transportation Committee on a 3-2 vote. The issue is being studied now by an army of consultants. Both Mayor Lyda Crewson and Board President Lewis Reed are in favor of studying whether it's best to turn the city's biggest asset, the airport, over to a private firm for something like 40 years. The city's chief financial officer, Comptroller Darlene Green, is against the idea. Supporters of the deal say a privatization firm would commit to giving the city a lump sum payment that could be $1 billion or more. Still, there's no guarantee the city would ever get all the money promised, and no one can guarantee the long-term fiscal well-being of the company that gets the contract if privatization is ultimately approved by city officials. Alderwoman Marlene Davis sits on the airport advisory board that's now studying whether privatization is a good idea. She voted against Alderwoman Kara Spencer's legislation to give voters a say.
What made you decide to oppose the bill to give voters the right to vote on airport privatization?
My main thing all along has been to have a bill that is comprehensive, that has the information on there, that can help a person decide how they'd like to vote. Currently, we don't have any information to share because the process is not anywhere near where even those who are representing the city can even make a decision one way or another.
On many small issues, yes, we represent the voice of our constituents, but on something as large as privatizing our city's single largest asset, our airport, the public really ought to be engaged in that process, and they ought to have a voice in the final decision by the city.
No other airport has been privatized in the continental United States. One facility, New York Stewart Airport, was privatized in 2000, but went back to being a publicly run airport 7 years later in 2007, when that airport's fortunes began to fade. Alderwoman Davis took exception to statements made by the head of the airport committee she sits on that aired on my recent You Paid For It. Budget Director Paul Payne said a couple of weeks ago in my interview with him that a decision on whether privatization is a good idea could come in a matter of months, not years, as had previously been said.
So the decision could be made to scrap the idea before 18 months?
It could, I mean, if it's not promising. But those are the kind of things that you look at as you pull them together.
At what point would you make that? Would you guys be?
Yeah, I'm not sure.
At what
sure.
milestone would you maybe?
Yeah, I'm not sure. I think in the next couple months we should have a good idea about what the projections are on both scenarios.
And it was so unfortunate that our director made the statement that he made a few weeks ago, because I think he was just confused.
Okay. Alderwoman Spencer says while her bill to give you a vote may be dead in the water for now, she says she's not giving up and will try to make another run at making sure you have a voice in this important issue affecting your airport. Of course, I'll stay on top of this deal. After all, you paid for it.